What will be the world's largest rocket? SpaceX's Starship is now going through some critical testing before its first orbital flight.
Western Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heiler explains why this next step is so complicated and what it means for the Cape.
SpaceX's Starship fully stacked on the launch pad in Texas, getting ready to be fully fueled for the very first time. A wet dress rehearsal.
You know, if you recall back with the Space Launch System in NASA, they did this countdown demonstration test and wet dress rehearsal 5 different times over the course of several months. And so, you know, SpaceX may not nail it the first time out, but this is a really big milestone ahead of them.
One difference with the Starship is that all the ground systems for the launch pad are all new, just over a year. New rocket, new pad, but it's also about the scale of the operation.
Just the amount, the volumes of propellant that are going into that massive vehicle, which is, you know, like a 30-story skyscraper. They're basically filling that with cryogenic propellants in a matter of an hour.
Even though the bulk of the rocket and launch testing for Starship has taken place at SpaceX's facility in South Texas, once the massive rocket becomes operational, it'll move here to the Space Coast. Part of NASA's commercial partnership with the Artemis program and deep space exploration.
As they mature that technology and become comfortable with the capabilities, it will move here. This is more the operations site, although I think it's a given. SpaceX is going to have these launch sites on a number of locations around the planet.
After a successful wet dress rehearsal, the next step after a few weeks, a static fire test. And then if all has gone well, the orbital test flight of the Starship could come in March. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.